Good afternoon, colony. My name is the Colonist, and we are going to be doing another Legend of Zelda, continuing our A Link to the Past playthrough of this. When we last left our hero, he had just gotten a new piece of heart, as you could see by our 5 hearts instead of 4. And this section, we are going to take on the first dungeon. So that is going to be very exciting. Hopefully it won't be too long of a game, of a video, but we got some green dudes to take over. There we go. No problem at all. We got one of those pink guys that we don't have to worry about anymore, because he is not where we're going. And I'm just going to freeze him and just walk away. And you notice they made little cute things, like they had an arrow in the grass here, like, ooh, how clever. But it's not that clever, FYI. And once again, just a little too late to the punch are the guards. I'm going to try and just kind of skip through most of the, go through most of the motions here. We still have to talk to the elder, because we only talked to the guy who knows the elder in the town, which was a complete waste of time, but that is what Link has to deal with, just put up with not giving direct answers, if we all recall Zelda's terrible directions by getting through the sewers. And she's still around. I mean, we did show up in the sanctuary, and she was still there. This guy, these little Octoroks that shoot clay balls at you, that's just wonderful. Why is an octopus walking on land? Is a great question. Got some more pots here. And this guy,
I am indeed Sahasrahla, the village elder and a descendant of the 7 wise men.
So I'm guessing this must be the elder. Oh, more ellipses points.
Oh, really? Colony, I am surprised a young man like you is searching for the Sword of Evil's Bane. Not just anyone can use that weapon. Let us say only a hero who has won the 3 pendants could wield the sword.
More ellipses points.
Do you really want to find it?
Nah, actually, not really. I didn't really want to. I was just kidding. I just wanted to see how you're doing, buddy. How you been?
Good. As a test, can you retrieve the Pendant of Courage from the East Palace?
Well, how is that a test if I need it? But it doesn't really make any sense. Okay.
If you bring it here, I'll tell you more of the legend and give you a magical artifact.
Oh, that's great. That's exactly what I need, is a fossil. A fossil is going to help me. I just realized we have no fairies or any red potion whatsoever. But you know what? That's okay, because I know where we can get some fairies in the actual castle itself. Oh no! Small Armos Knights. Those take 4 shots to kill them. I love how it's just, it wakes up and just hops at you. Oh, and you can use the boomerang, and I don't get why the orange color. I don't get how that's supposed to signify danger. But, I mean, I'm not the one who made this game, so more thwacking, more useless arrows. But the good news is, not too long from now, I'm going to be getting what we need to use to shoot those arrows. And you're probably wondering why I didn't use the bomb at Sahasrahla's place, and that will be explained as soon as we're done with the pendant. And here's another blue guy who apparently does not know how to walk downstairs. And I'm just not even going to bother with these guys. And here we go. Palace number 1, the East Palace, I think is what it's called. And we are looking for a door to open. That would be that. I've got these weird tentacle creatures, which just kind of run away from you. I'm not sure how that's security or whatnot, but oh, I've got some cyclop eye-looking creatures, and someone is hurling cannonballs at us. Oh, look at that. I don't know why someone is deciding to hurl cannonballs. I wonder who's in charge of that. I wonder who's taking charge of hurling cannonballs at oncoming people. Oh, and I got some money, 100 rupees, and some more money on the side. Okay, I could take money. Money's good. And this is the first dungeon. This is the first one other than, obviously, the castle. But if you don't count the castle, then this is the first dungeon. We got some skeleton guys. Gonna lift some more pots. Let's lift some pots. Oh, I thought that might hit him. That would have been cool. Alright, let's go to the right and see what awaits us here. More skeleton dudes. And, these are the coward skeletons because they just like running away, just hopping away from you. Ha ha! Ha ha! Oh, and I hit them both times, so they didn't really run away. Can't get me. Well, you're now backed in a corner, bitch. Take my green sword of doom. Go. We've got a couple options. Well, let's go up first. And, looks like we got one of those magic and life pentagons. I'm not even sure what you'd call it. It's got a skull on it. That's all I know. And, what is this? This is the map. Got the map, that piece of parchment that we got the other place. Why do they keep it in a treasure chest? No need. Well, first off, the guards should just know what is going on. You know, they should know the layout of their map. There shouldn't need to be a map hidden in a treasure chest randomly. And, oh, we're back in here. So, let's go back out, and let's take the other way. Let's take left. Open the door again. Hopefully that opens the other side as well. And it did. Good to know. More hearts and nothing. I love how there's nothing ever in the pots. It's just always under the pots that you get stuff. Oh, that didn't stop him. I thought the boomerang might stop him, but it does not. Well, but they don't run away, at least, from the boomerang. Only the sword, because they obviously know which one is going to do more damage. I mean, a sharp sword or a curved piece of wood. Obviously, a sword's gonna win out on that. And we're just kind of chilling in here, wondering what's going on. Oh, what's this? More of these skeleton creatures. These mythical skeletons. I love that their skulls are cracked. Like, they're not even full skeletons. Like, they all took some sort of blunt force trauma. Maybe some guy came in here and already hit them with the boomerang. And that's why they all have cracked skulls. Got another treasure chest, and it is the compass. So now we can know where the boss or boss is, depending on how many there are in the little chamber are. And what is this? Colony, it is I, Sahasrahla! I can talk to you telepathically when you touch these tiles. Here is a hint. You can use the treasure hidden in this palace to defeat armored foes. Wonderful, that is good news. Let's see, can I get by here? No, I cannot. But it's helpful to know that what I get in here is going to help me win. And, what is this frog-looking creature? Oh, and I got hit by one of the multiple more skull creatures. Wonderful. That's exactly what we need, is running skull creatures everywhere. Blunt force trauma skeletons. Here we go. And, wonder what happened. Oh, jeez! Giant eye creatures. That did not look pleasant. And there's another one over here. Luckily, using the pots kills them, but I don't think I could hit them with a sword. Now I'm gonna go get my fairies. And no, I'm not talking about Dungeons and Dragons or whatever you other people play. Oh look, two fairies! Oh, I caught one! Keep it in a bottle. Let's keep the other one in a bottle too, seeing how we have two bottles. Now what happens is, when you get fairies, if you die, you are brought back to life by fairy magic. Just what every person wants is to be magically brought back to life by fairies. Oh, it's dark in here. Wonder what's going on. Oh, another one of those tentacle creatures. Oh, that door opens. Another tentacle creature. I got two of those guys chasing after me. Alright, back in the dark. Oh, more blunt force trauma skeletons. Who also disappear in a puff of smoke, but they're already dead. I'm not really sure how that works, but I guess that's just the Legend of Zelda for you. I got a small key, so hopefully I will not get hit by those. I'm not even sure what to call those. Those pink discs, I guess. Those skull discs that are going out of their way to sap both magic power and health from you. We'll call them double whammies. Why not? Because they are indeed a double. Oh, and there's four double whammies. That would be eight. That'd be octuple whammies. Got another green guy. More tentacle creature. More blunt force trauma. Maybe that's why they're here, because they're so used to the boomerang that they're just running away from anything short because they know they can avoid it. They're so used to being hit with the boomerang. Thus the blunt force trauma. Oh, and they all just went sporadically out of the way. Maybe. Hopefully I won't get hit. Oh, another treasure chest. Oh, and I got the big cow skull key. So, trying to run away from this. Oh, I got hit.
And it took a whole heart away from me, and when you only have 5 hearts, that is pretty detrimental. More blunt force trauma skeletons. And, oh, and these guys are back. Everybody's back. This is just respawn at central right here. Oh, jeez. And I will, oh, still took him out. Look at that. It's pretty effective. I'm not even going to hit this guy. Let's see what's in here. It is the bow. You can shoot arrows until you run out. We now have a use for all those pointless arrows. Oh, what's, whoa, we got heads here. What's happening? Whoa. I guess blunt force trauma skulls. Just the skulls coming out to get me. So just the blunt force trauma, the only part that's really affected by blunt force trauma.
Alright, in here now, we've got decent amount of people. Oh, there's one of those guys. Oh, he's awake too. But I got a key out of it. More of these tentacle guys who just are no trouble at all. It's not even worth the attempt. It is pretty dark in here. We could shed some light on the situation. Okay. We got the key. We opened up. We have a key, so we can go in the other way. I just want to see what's in here. And it's money! And more of those double whammy guys. Oh, which hit me again. Only have 2 hearts left. I gotta be careful now. Gotta play strategy here. But see, it's okay, because if I die, I have two of the guys there. So, not even this. I have 2 fairies. So, and that is good news food. That's the best kind of news and the best kind of food. More double whammy guys. Got a heart. That's helpful. Open the door. Wish you could kill those double whammy guys, but you cannot. 3 of the third eye blind creatures. Seeing how, or whatever those ear things are. I guess they're ears. I'm not really sure. Oh, jeez. Got hit again. And you have to go near him to wake him up, which is just annoying. Why don't you just stay awake and come at me? You know what I mean? But here we go. And there's the door. Got 4 levers there. You know what I never understood in this game, though, is why have this whole dungeon here just to protect a pendant? Like, couldn't you just hold it with somebody you trust? But I guess that would take away... And who's flinging all these cannonballs? Why do you have this entire cannonball defense system? Unnecessary. You've got all these blunt force... Oh, you know what probably happened to all these blunt force trauma guys? They probably got hit by cannonballs. That would make sense. They're trying to get in... They were all former Links who tried to get into and beat the Armos Knights, but didn't because they got ran over by the cannonballs. And therefore, they have cracked skulls because the cannonballs just got shot into their brain. And here we go. Got more of these pink guys which take arrows. You can't use any pots on them, but you can use arrows. Multiple arrows are what's going to get them. And I think coming up, we've got our boss battle. So let's see who our first dungeon in. And oh, it is giant ass Armos Knights. Who just like hopping in a hexagon. Why not go after me? Why are you dancing? There's no point to dancing. Okay, I'm not understanding. Let's just dance around and hope that we hit him. But that's not winning. I could just stand in the corner and pick you all off. This is not a good strategy by these bosses. Like, why don't you go after me? Oh, one of them took my advice. Look at that. He also turned pink randomly. I guess when you realize you're the only one left, you get kind of berserked. He's only taken a half a life by stomping on me. This is like no effort at all. There we go. That was like nothing. But terrible strategy by the first boss. And maybe that's why I defeated them so easily. But we now have the Pendant of Courage. Because this was before the whole Triforce idea. And having it be the Triforce of Courage, but I mean it does show up later. So we can't say that it's not there at all. You won the Pendant of Courage. Take it to Sahasrahla. 2 pendants remain. I don't see how this was a test, though. Because this was like, it was no trouble at all. I mean, we cruised through this dungeon. We're not even going to give these little Armos Knights the light of day. Like, we're not even going to recognize that they're even here. We're just going to go right by him, go to Sahasrahla, get whatever it is he's going to give us. So, hello, Sahasrahla. What's up?
Oh, you got the Pendant of Courage. Now I will tell you more of the legend. 3 or 4 generations ago, an order of knights protected the loyalty of Hylia. These knights of Hyrule were also guardians of the Pendant of Courage. Unfortunately, most of them were destroyed in the great war against evil that took place when the 7 wise men created their seal. Among the descendants of the knights of Hyrule, a hero must appear.
Okay, alright, I see. Colony, I believe you. You should get the remaining I didn't say anything, what are you talking about?
You believe me in what? And carry this with you. It is a treasure passed down by the families of the wise men. I want you to have it.
You gave me boots. Wow. Talk about, like, the creepy uncle from Christmas.
What did you give me? I got your boots. So now you can run away when I'm trying to do things to you after I hand you a beer. Now you can execute a devastating dash attack.
Yippee.
A helpful item is hidden in a cave on the east side of Hylia. Lake Hylia, get it.
I assume he's referring to the Zora slippers. But here's the reason why I didn't do anything here. Because, oh look at that, I could just run into it. So, it's going to make us walk around a little bit faster. We got some bombs, yippee. Got some rupees. Oh, I just walked out. That was not intended. And, oh, more rupees.
Yay!
Good, now I can buy some potions, but actually, my bottles are full of fairies, because we didn't even, that was, like, not even, like, difficult in the slightest. So, I think that's gonna do it for this video, going through the first temple. My name is The Colonist, and I will see you next time, everybody. Take care.